Drew Carey's wild tour of Hollywood at the right price. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Everlasting Luxury. Here is Drew Carey's wild tour of Hollywood at the right price. Cleveland is a great city to visit. Drew Carey does, too. The comedian has reinvented himself, achieved success, and amassed a fortune. Since his ascension to Hollywood stardom, Drew Carey has played a variety of roles and pursued a variety of goals. He has his self-titled show, has filled in as a host on some of the most popular shows, and has returned to his roots as a stand-up comedian. However, there were many trials and tribulations along the way that caused trips and missteps on his way to becoming one of the most beloved television personalities. Carey has proven himself in a variety of styles, genres, and audiences, from improv master to calculated comedian. On The Price is Right, he established his family-friendly attitude, and on The Drew Carey Show and Whose Line Is It Anyway, he adored improv fans and sketch show fans, and he managed to combine the two in a career bookended by stand-up comedy. All of this is on top of serving in the United States Marine Corps as a veteran. Carey's diverse accomplishments, as well as his willingness to overcome adversity, have earned him a reputation unlike any other Hollywood star. Through sound judgment, the ability to persevere in the face of adversity. Humble beginnings. Carey attended Kent State University before his big break in the world of television, where he was expelled twice for poor grades. Carey dropped out in his third year and enlisted in the United States Marine Corps Reserve in 1980, where he served as a radio operator in Ohio for 6 years. Carey then relocated to Las Vegas, Nevada, where he worked as everything from a bank teller to a waiter. Carey did not start doing stand-up comedy until 1985, a skill that would set him apart and propel him into the spotlight. He quickly rose through the ranks, eventually becoming the master of ceremonies at his local Cleveland Comedy Club and a guest on Star Search in 1988. In 1991, he gained national attention when he appeared on The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson and Late Night with David Letterman. The Drew Carey Show. Carey began acting after gaining fame as a comedian by appearing on several late-night shows, including a role in the 1993 film Coneheads and a role on NBC's The Good Life. His timing skills quickly became apparent, and he was asked to contribute to the series Someone Like Me as a writer. The project introduced Carey to Bruce Helford, and the two formed a partnership that resulted in a pitch for The Drew Carey Show, a semi-autobiographical series. With 9 seasons and over 233 episodes, ABC picked up The Drew Carey Show, making it one of the longest-running sitcoms. Not only did Carey's comedy improve throughout the series, but so did his budget. Carey was paid $60,000 per episode in the beginning, but this quickly increased to $300,000 per episode, and by the show's final season, he was earning an estimated $750,000 per episode. Improv Trooper. After The Drew Carey Show was cancelled, in part due to its exorbitant budget of $3 million per episode, Carey returned to his comedic roots by focusing on a series of improv-based shows. Carey was a founding member of the Improv All-Stars, a touring comedy troupe that performed in comedy clubs and other venues around the world. Several members of the improv group went on to star in his television improv shows. Drew Carey's Green Screen Show, Drew Carey's Improvaganza, and Whose Line Is It Anyway were among them. Game Show Guru. Drew Carey debuted on the game show scene in 2007 as the host of CBC's short-lived Power of 10 show. Carey was tapped by CBS as a possible replacement for The Price is Right's long-serving Bob Barker shortly after recording the show's pilot. In 2007, Carey hosted his first episode, and he quickly established himself as a regular on the show. He kept working on the show, meeting a diverse cast of characters from the audience and grew to enjoy it. Carey was soon celebrating his 10th year on the show in 2017, a feat that only he and Barker had accomplished with the show. Personal tragedies and triumphs. Carey's personal and professional lives changed dramatically the following year. He was able to lose 80 pounds, which is a remarkable achievement. He began appearing on celebrity competition shows such as Dancing with the Stars and The Masked Singer before returning to stand-up comedy, which had launched him on his wild and winding career path. Despite his turbulent personal life and career, Carey continues to explore his passions and interests in a variety of ways, surprising and delighting his audiences. Drew Carey married sex therapist Amy Harwick in 2018. The couple broke up in November after their engagement but remained close afterward. Harwick was discovered dead in her Hollywood Hills home in February of 2020. The event was shrouded in mystery, and before long, a subject was discovered in the most unlikely of places. On the Kill Tony podcast, which was recorded live at the world-famous Comedy Story main room, one of Harwick's ex-boyfriends was a guest. Following his arrest, news stations interviewed several members of the podcast, inquiring about the suspicious character whose performance elicited curious suspicions from the audience. Carey has talked about the situation and shared his experiences. Thank you for watching.